Make this person wear a hat. Change the weather from sunny to cloudy. Make its fur white. This is InstructPix2Pix. Hey there, welcome to LearnOpenCV. In this video, we will learn about InstructPix2Pix and deploy it locally. Editing images using masking and inpainting is called image to image. If we give an image and prompt instructions to InstructPix2Pix, then the model will follow the instructions to edit the image. You can employ InstructPix2Pix to create applications like virtual makeup and digitally try on clothes. Let's check out the official Gradio app. Let's load an example. On the left side, we have an input image and on the top, we have the edit instruction. We pass both of them to the model and we get the edited image. We'll learn more about these options later on in the video. Now let's deploy the official InstructPix2Pix model on Stable Diffusion Web UI. We'll be using Google Colab for our deployment. We are running on a V100 GPU, but the model will also work nicely on a T4 GPU. We start with cloning the Web UI repository from Automatic 1111, and then we download the official InstructPix2Pix Stable Diffusion model. InstructPix2Pix is a variation of the Stable Diffusion model. Instead of an image generation model, that is text to image, it is an image editing diffusion model. We need to save the model in the Web UI's model/StableDiffusion directory. Next, we will deploy the UI by executing python launch.py --share. The share argument will give us an shareable URL. Since we are running on Colab, we need the shareable URL. But if you are deploying on a local system, the local URL will suffice. Web UI takes time to install the dependencies. Once done, open the public URL. This is our Web UI. Let's switch to the Image to Image tab. We can work with the InstructPix2Pix model here. We'll upload a photo of a dog. Look at his smile, such a good boy. Let's change the color of its fur to white. Before we click on Generate, let's edit a few parameters. We will resize the image by a scale of 0.5 and increase the sampling steps to 80. A high sample step generally gives a good result. We learn more about CFG scale and image CFG scale at the end of the video. Now, click on Generate and give it a few seconds. Here is a generated image. Now let's make its fur dirty. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. InstructPix2Pix is a multimodal model which deals with both texts and images. Most of InstructPix2Pix is similar to the original Stable Diffusion model. It still has a large transformer-based text encoder, an autoencoder network that encodes images to the latent space, a UNET model that works in the latent space to predict the noise, and the decoder that decodes the final output of the UNET and upsamples it. Let's understand how InstructPix2Pix was trained. First, the GPT-3 model was trained on 700 captions of Lion aesthetic dataset, as well as manually created edit instructions and edited captions. For example, our input caption can be "a cat sitting on a couch." The edit instruction can be "cat wearing a hat." In this case, the final caption will be "a cat wearing a hat sitting on a couch." Once GPT-3 is trained, we only input captions to the model. The model then outputs edit instruction and the final caption. Around 450,000 captions are generated this way, which will now be used to train the Stable Diffusion model. The Stable Diffusion model is trained on the input caption and the edited caption and the original image. However, there is an issue. The Stable Diffusion models tend to generate very different images, even with similar prompts. This is because the model treats both the captions independently. Hence, the authors employed prompt to prompt to generate similar images. Now, the model uses prompt-to-prompt generated images to refine the Stable Diffusion output, kind of like a ground truth for the generations. To run inference, however, just the input image and the edit instruction is given to the model. The paper states, "Despite being trained with generated images and editing instructions, our model is able to generalize the editing real images using arbitrary human-written instructions." Cool! During inference, we need a way to tell the model where to focus more, the image or text. This is achieved through classifier-free guidance, which weighs over two conditional inputs, ST and SI, for text and image respectively. Guiding the model to ST will condition the final image closer to the text prompt. Similarly, guiding the model more towards SI will make the final image closer to the input image. So, that's all about InstructPix2Pix. If you like this video, why don't you check out our top 10 AI art generation tools or other videos in the AI art generation playlist. Do comment on what you would like to see next and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Until next time.